The plan of organizing this National Cycling World Championship was centered around the Cycling Federation of Nigeria. The federation provided a veritable template, contacts with various stakeholders and the political class for diligent guide on the requirements for budget proposal, approval and implementation on the expectations towards our success. The trip attracted 168 cyclists and 30 team officials from all over the country. The technical director of the Cycling Federation conducted a guided tour of the 48 km per lap road race, traversing the 12 newly built flyovers and roads within Port Harcourt and Oyapo Metropolis. This was a precondition for certification of the route before the race, and he expressed satisfaction. The four-category race was flagged off at 7:45 a.m. by Chief Solomon Omar, first vice president of the Nigeria Olympic Committee, NOC, representing Engineer Habu Gumel, president of the Nigeria Olympic Committee. The elite male and elite female took the lead, and after 5 minutes, the junior male and junior female followed on the same route. A joint decision of the State Transition Committee and the Cycling Federation approved the start and finish points on Ada George Road by the Carpenters Church. It went through Ikwere Road, Mile 3 to Mile 1 flyover, UTC Junction to Azikiwe Road, Station Road, and returned to UTC Junction. Then Aba Road to Rumokurushi, through Rumokurushi flyover to East West Road, to Obirikwere flyover to NTA Ngboba Road, then to Rumokuta flyover and back to Ngboba flyover into Ada George, the finish point, a lap of 48 kilometers. The junior females completed one lap, while the junior male and female elite completed two laps. That is 96 kilometers, with the male elite completing three laps, 144 kilometers. We'll be right back. winners and two runners-up were handsomely rewarded with cash, trophies, medals, and certificates.
Dedication, we talk about service, and we talk about hard work. Now, for more than 10 years in this state, the Cycling Association, of which the current CFN president was strongly a part of, was hailed as one of the best associations here in the state. Now, when I say was hailed, this was done by not only sports writers, not only journalists, but at least from most previous people who see that those who partake in cycling were up and about and doing something. This man was a very strong contributor to all that's happened, and is still a strong contributor to all that's happened here in River State concerning cycling, and he's of course now CFN president. Permit me to call Engineer Chief Gian Domenico Vasari.
It is with great delight that I welcome all esteemed guests and participants to this epoch, Mikey. Indeed, it is very first time that any major sport event shall be granted an executive approval in the lineup of program of government during a transition. We therefore say a big thank you, Mr. Quality Project, and the most celebrated governor, His Excellency Barrister Nelson Ezewo Wike, CONGSSRS, Life Venture, for creating this platform and the execution of Money Transforming Landscape Project in River State. Let me also thank the Nigeria Olympic Committee for the several interventions and support for the Team Nigeria at various international competitions. Finally, I thank the Chairman and member of the State Transition Committee, of the support agency and the media for the cooperation toward the success of this National Cycling Championship in Portugal. Permit me to pledge that we are committed to make this an annual championship. Thanks you all, and may God bless you, His Excellency Barrister Nelson Ezewo Wike, CONGSSRS, Life Venture, as he steps into an awaiting greater responsibility with expectation for quality service delivery to this country, Nigeria. We hope to converge again in 2024 for more celebration.
I thank God, and I want to specially thank the Cycling Federation for considering us worthy of recognition today by this great honor of award. You found something that made you choose Port Harcourt as a place to showcase to the world in terms of infrastructural development.
President of the Cycling Federation of Nigeria and members of your board, the President of
Dr. Tami Danagogo, Secretary to the River State Government, represented the Executive Governor of River State, His Excellency Barrister Yusuf Ezewo Wike, CONGSSRS, Life Venture.
Choosing Port Harcourt and for coming to grace this event, I want to tell all the young men and women who took part in this game, in this event, that you are all winners. So on behalf of the governor, I welcome you all, and I want to thank you for choosing River State for this national ceremony.
Federation of Nigeria have decided that some outstanding individuals and organizations will be given awards today for what they have done in contribution to sports and also development in general in Rivers State and Nigeria at large. So I would like to call once again on the CFM president as we have this presented. Engineer Masari, please will you step forward please, as we have these special awards presented. Now first on the list to receive an award today is the construction giant Julius Berger. You see, of course, the works that have been paid for here in Rivers State, but also they have delivered. We'd also like to call on the Commissioner of Police, Rivers State, CP Okon Efion Okon, who is here represented by the DC, Usman Kafani Jibrin. Please, a round of applause for the Commissioner of Police. And the CFN has said he merits an award, and that award is being presented by the President CFN to them. Please, another round of applause for them. I would like to call on a representative of Alabo, Freddy Anababa, to pick up an award also from the CFN. As we're here, they will also give a special shout out to Alabo, Freddy Anababa. Please, I would like to call forward Dr. Sam Jaja. Please, a big round of applause for him. An ambassador of cycling. Call for a special award is no other person than Dr. Tammy Danagogo. So also, it's indeed quite important. Please, a round of applause for Dr. Tammy Danagogo. Dr. Ngozi Ordu, the Deputy Governor-elect, to have a representative pick up the award for her.
The Cycling Federation of Nigeria presented plaques of honor to seven major dignitaries, including His Excellency Barrister Yesom Ezenwo-Wike, the incoming Governor of Rivers State, and the incoming Deputy Governor of Rivers State. All participants and guests were happy with the event.
All smiles as she takes her medal and trophy. And she, of course, will be going home with a check of 300,000 naira. Ukwesiara picking up her medal and trophy. Big congratulations to, of course, the cyclists here.
Consolation cash prizes were presented to the other seven finishers in the four category events to boost the morale of the athletes.
I feel so excited. My gratitude goes to everyone that made this a progress. To the governor, His Excellency, everyone that made this a success.
My name is Akosi Abaka, representing Bayelsa. I'm happy to win the championship like this, and I'm saying a very big thank you to the Rivers State government and the Cycling Federation of Nigeria for putting up a very big race like this.
I'm so very excited because it has been long I race in Nigeria. I'm very super excited for being here and to represent my state.
It is nice event. They did it well for us.
Remarks by the participants afterwards confirmed that this was a colorful and life-changing one-day sporting event on the continent of Africa.